Culling is a process in the rendering pipeline that removes all invisible objects from the camera's point of view. This process gives us performance boost by drawing only what is needed. There are two popular types of culling that are commonly used in games and applications. The first one is called View Frustum Culling. It allows you to clip all objects that are outside of the camera's point of view and not to render them. This process is built into all modern game engines, including Unity, because you can basically run it for free. You cannot disable it or easily preview its effects, but here is an example of how it can look for our main camera in a scene. The second one is called Occlusion Culling, and it's a process of removing objects that are occluded, or simply covered up by rendering other objects in front of them. In Unity 3D, when it comes to Occlusion Culling, we have a built-in third-party tool called Umbra. Umbra, like many other tools that come with Unity, has quite limited functionality, but it can be used to enhance performance of simple static scenes. Umbra uses a point cloud algorithm to detect what should be rendered, and what not, from a predefined position on the scene. First, we need to define the area in which we want to bake this algorithm and what parameters to apply for it. Due to algorithm chosen by Umbra developers, its quality suffers heavily. It ignores small holes or windows and disregards content behind them, leading to obvious quality issues. It's also sloppy when it comes to fully occluded objects, and when include them, and thus lowering performance gains. This low baking quality allows for pretty fast iteration and baking time, and allow developers to gain rapid performance boosts. There are several glaring issues with this solution. Occlusion can only be used from a main scene, where additional scenes will not load occlusion data. You cannot load a variant of a scene that has changed at runtime without completely reloading the scene. And the performance gain is mediocre at best. That's why we developed Precomputed Culling. Unlike the aforementioned built-in tool, it uses a pixel-perfect baking algorithm in which no small details will be missed in the final result. All of this while hiding all objects that are truly invisible for the biggest performance boost. This asset is now available on Asset Store, link in the description. To start using Precomputed Culling, simply import it into your project. There are three main components of the tool that you should keep in mind before you start baking. To get started quickly, in the navigation menu, simply press Tools, Precomputed Culling, and Setup. The first component was added to the main camera of the scene. The script needs to know which camera we'll be looking through. If you are using virtual cameras in your project, you need to add this script manually for each camera if they will be looking at the geometry. This is to inform the script that we should not hide objects visible to those cameras. Here we can see some useful statistics, such as the number of volumes and cameras, and also the number of currently visible and culled objects in the scene. In terms of configuration, here we can completely disable culling for debugging purposes, as well as change the minimum required visibility and radius of neighboring cells. More on this later. The most important component is the area, or sometimes called the volume, which will be used to bake and resolve occlusions during runtime for cameras inside the area. Let's describe how volume should behave. Here we can change the division of the area. This allows us to split the entire volume into smaller parts, which allows for greater baking resolution, thus increasing performance. The smaller the cell, the better the quality. As a rule of thumb, for interiors and dense cities, 1 meter for X and Z coordinates, and for open worlds, 5 to 10 meters, keeping Y at the height of the camera while jumping or walking. Each cell has its own baking data, which will be applied at runtime to the camera to check visibility. Given that the algorithm uses pixel-perfect color coding, we need to define the points that are inside the cell where baking will take place. At those points, the script will place a 360 camera during baking, which will scan the surrounding and save the results into a file. Generated results from multiple cameras within a cell are combined, so if one renderer is visible from any camera, it will be visible from the entire cell. This is the key concept of the algorithm, where one area equals one set of renderers that will be visible to the active camera. In order to prevent artifacts from appearing and achieve the best results, it's important to set the number of bake spots per cell to 3x3 minimum. Remember the neighbor cell radius from the camera script? It's used to define whether a single cell equals single visibility data, or multiple combined cells, which will be used to check visibility. Setting this number to 1 will take a single neighbor cell and make sure that all objects visible from any of those cells, both to the one camera is currently in and a nearby neighbor, are visible. This saves baking time and reduces object popping when looking around the corner. Similar results can be achieved by putting more baking spots into the cell itself, which in the same time increases by cell baking time, but ensures quality around the corners. Those baking spots can be offset from each other to make sure that the most critical baking area is covered by each cell. If you decide not to set neighbor cells, it's recommended to include at least 9 spots per cell. Above the setting of neighbor cells, it's minimum required visibility, given that each baking spot is basically a 360 camera with a certain number of pixels per renderer. We can determine how many of those pixels were used to see a given object. We store this number to allow us to hide small objects that wouldn't be seen. By default, a texture of 1024 by 1024 is used to the entire panoramic view. Increasing the minimal number of visibility required will decrease rendering quality, but might allow for a few more FPS for players with slower hardware. This setting can be changed freely for each camera during the game runtime, allowing each player to customize their experience with this setting. Minimum required visibility setting is independent of the level of detail component, LOD in short, and always assumes the highest object quality during the baking process. Given that the precomputed culling algorithm works by rendering and visibility checking every pixel in the scene, we skip both transparent materials and sprites. Those objects will not be cooled when the algorithm runs. Because of this, we may lose some important performance gains that we might get otherwise. To improve the quality of baking, we give you an option to make each baking for each area a multipass. Those areas will perform a double bake, which will take twice as long, but will include transparent objects and or sprites. Those bakes will make the first pass without transparency objects and sprites, to see what's behind them in order to render them correctly. Then, they will make a second pass with sprites and transparent meshes as fully opaque, so that the algorithm can see them and decide whether they are visible or not. This option, for some scenes, can provide a much-needed performance boost. Due to the limitations of the Unity engine, by default, Unity terrain components will not be baked. To include them, we need to convert each terrain to a mesh and use it for baking. This option, unlike the first two multipass options, will not add a second baking, but will increase the baking time by processing terrain to a simple 3D mesh. In this video, we will not touch upon settings, as it's for more advanced use cases, like procedural terrain, multi-scene composition, and scene variants. For those topics, please visit the documentation or ask questions at our Discord. With this knowledge, we can press the bake button. This will bake all areas in the currently open scene or multiple scenes if they are currently loaded in the editor. Please note that each game object with LOD or renderer got added a new component, Precomputed Culling Renderer ID. This component is used to preserve bake data between minor changes to the scene, especially during runtime. New objects and hierarchy changes will not affect the final results. The ID field is open for editing, but changing it might affect the bake result. To preview the results, you can check each area and see what has been baked. As you can see, each cell has its own visibility data baked into it, which will be triggered when the player's camera, with the culling script enabled, is inside. Please note that if any camera is outside of this area, which includes the occlusion culling script, it will disable the whole algorithm. This is because we have to make sure that each camera has a proper feed into it, and when one of them is out, we no longer know what should be rendered and what not. Before we jump into performance, we need to establish common metrics that we will use to compare solutions. Those will be batches, triangles and vertices, as well as set pass calls, also known as draw calls. Those are key metrics that we will be looking at to measure performance gains. Note that we won't be looking at either FPS or rendering thread CPU time, as those variables will be different for each user hardware and ultimately just a result of all the components mentioned above. Triangles and vertices count are almost self-explanatory. Triangles are often abbreviated as tris, are the simplest form of a polygon in a 3D model. Every model you see in the game is made up of thousands of even millions of those tiny triangles. The more complex the model, the more triangles it will consist of. So when we talk about the number of triangles, we are essentially talking about complexity of 3D models in the scene. On the other hand, vertices are points where those triangles meet. Each triangle has three vertices, which store crucial data. This data can include information such as position, color, normal, and texture coordinates. It's important to remember that vertices not only affect the shape of your model, but also its shading and texturing. Batches represent the number of draw calls that the CPU sends to the GPU. Each batch contains information about the model, textures used, shaders applied, and other similar details. Reducing the number of batches can significantly improve the game performance, especially on lower-end systems. Set pass calls or draw calls are part of those batches. Each set pass call represents a change in the rendering state. For example, changing a material or shader will result in new set pass call. It's important to keep those to a minimum, as each call has a performance cost. Now, armed with this knowledge, let's compare Precomputed Culling and Umbra. We'll use the same path for each test. The number of set pass calls for non-occlusion data hovers at around 60. When built-in Unity occlusion solution is enabled, we can see slight improvement over the baseline, that's around 5%. The situation drastically changes when we do a pass with Precomputed Culling. The average number of set pass calls with Precomputed Culling is almost halved, that hovers at around 30. Now we'll focus on triangles. The number, without occlusion, hovers at around 7.5 million. Umbra, in this example, gives us 15% improvement over raw data. As with previous graph, the improvement is small, but noticeable. Finally, we come to Precomputed Culling, which again dominates the graph, giving us huge boost in performance compared to other solutions. Compared to best case scenario, over 9 times better and 7 times better than Umbra. Lastly, batches. In the demo scene, the graph looks similar to triangles, as buildings are mostly of the same complexity. With Umbra, another noticeable improvement, but nothing too crazy. For all the tests, we use recommended settings, but with Precomputed Culling, this might be not the end of the performance boost. You could easily gain another 30% by just reducing the quality by lowering down minimum required visibility. Precomputed Culling asset is now available in Asset Store. If you want to learn more about it, please join our Discord or visit our documentation page. Thank you.